Most often when people envision flooding, they picture massive rainstorms filling yards and basements or rivers cresting over their banks. But according to Barbara Robinson, president of Norton Engineering, one of the most common types of household flooding isn't caused by rain, but by brand new leaky sewer pipes. And Barbara Robinson joins us now to explain. Thanks for coming in on this. Okay, this sounds like a kind of bizarre first question, but how much leaking are we talking about here?
So my research has specifically been in new subdivisions, so new builds. Mm-hmm. We build brand new sewers and brand new storm sewers, both under the street and on the private lot.
And the we is municipalities.
It's developers actually do the building.
They do it, okay.
Yeah. We allow a teeny bit of leakage in engineering. There's a small amount because it's construction. Mm-hmm. Data collected from 60 subdivisions across Ontario is showing that pipes are leaking 10, 15 times more than they should be. I mean, an enormous amount. And, you know, you think of a little bit of water in sewers, oh, what's the big deal? Mm-hmm. A garden hose, which is a liter a second of water, is about the flow that you'll see in a garden hose. Mm-hmm. That costs $95,000 a year to treat at a wastewater treatment plant. So we're treating this clean water. It's using up capacity in our sewers. So there are development freezes around, and that capacity is getting used up by clean water that shouldn't be there. And then with the advent of climate change, when we have a lot of extra water around the pipes and around the foundation or whatever, the risk, it has to increase the risk of flood. It's absolutely connected.
Can you quantify how much water is leaking out of all these pipes?
Well, yeah. So basically, I have data sets, like I said, from across Ontario. If I took a section that isn't leaking all that badly, there was 2 liters a second of unacceptable water coming out of that particular subdivision, 120 homes. When I multiply that by the kinds of development we're expecting to see around the GTA, York, Halton, Peel, by year 2041, depending on the rate of growth, it's going to be in the trillions of dollars just to treat this water, much less convey it and the climate change impacts. And furthermore, we have to expand sewage treatment plants when they get too full. If a bunch of the water going in there is just water that shouldn't be there, we have a problem.
Do developers not know how to lay pipe anymore, or what's the problem here?
Well, it's actually a pretty complex issue. Firstly, until about 10 years ago, we didn't even know this was happening. So I've been working in sewers for my whole career, 30 years, sewer systems, all kinds, everything in sewers you can imagine I've done. We always assumed that brand new subdivisions would be leak-free. So we never assigned leakage values to them because we didn't think they'd be leaking. But 10 years ago, I accidentally stumbled across a subdivision. I was doing flow monitoring for something else and noticed that the flows had gone up.
Where was it?
St. Jacobs, Ontario.
Okay.
And so when I opened my own company 4 years ago, I thought, you know, I've seen this around Kitchener-Waterloo region. I bet you it's a bigger problem than this. So then I started working across Ontario. So it's basically 51 out of 52 subdivisions for which I have data are leaking unacceptably.
51 out of 52?
Yes, yes. And, I mean, 60 subdivisions doesn't seem like a large data set. However, we don't typically flow monitor new subdivisions because we always assume they weren't leaking. Mm-hmm. So now in Ontario, in the last couple of years, a lot of municipalities are starting to put flow monitoring at the downstream end of a subdivision because we know that this is a problem that was heretofore unrecognized.
What do you figure it's costing municipalities every year?
Oh, I couldn't even, it depends on, it's hard to say that apart from the treatment cost, because it depends on whether there are development freezes or the circumstances of the drainage area. Hmm. So, but the reasons why this is happening, and so I have the data that I started with, but then I started interviewing hundreds of people across Ontario, everybody in the development industry, building inspectors, municipal inspectors, contractors, consultants, and I spend a lot of time on site watching. And firstly, the guidelines, standards, and codes that we work by are not are in some cases not adequate to prevent this leakage. But more importantly, the guidelines, standards, and codes we work under all require that the sewers be leak tested before they're put into service.
And are they?
No. Uh-huh. 70% of municipalities in Ontario are not leak testing the public side sewer. That's the one under the street. Mm-hmm. It's costly, contractors complain, it takes too long, you have to stop construction and put plugs in and wait. But more alarmingly, on the private side, so that's the piece of sewer that you'll own when you buy your house, up to from your house to the property line, 95% of building departments are not testing that lateral. And it is called for in the Ontario Building Code. again, takes too long. You know, developers, builders want to move along. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, if we're not leak testing sewers and we find later that they're leaking, you know, we've lost an opportunity to prevent that leakage from happening.
What do they actually, do they redig and fix at that point?
Well, no, nobody knew this was happening. So all the subdivisions that have been built before we got onto this, who knows what's going on? What I'm recommending to municipalities now is put a flow monitor at the downstream end. We look at the flows, and I can calculate how much leakage is allowable for those particular circumstances. Mm-hmm. And if it's above that leakage, I mean, it's not quite rocket science, Steve, because there are a few factors involved or whatever. So as long as what I see is near the allowable leakage, that's close enough. But when I see it's 10 or 20 times higher than it's supposed to be, then the municipality maybe doesn't release the monies back to the developer until he goes and fixes it.
And are they open to making those changes you've recommended?
Development is a powerful industry, and
it sounds like a no.
You may think that, I couldn't possibly say.
Well, it does sound at the very least incredibly wasteful.
It's
Would you say that?
Incredibly. Oh, absolutely. It's criminal. It's really unbelievable this is happening.
Were they doing it better back in the day?
Well, yeah, that's an interesting question. It would be my observation and those of other people, although I don't have a hard data set. Stuff built in the last 20 years is not functioning as well as the last 40 years or the last 60 years. So when we decide when to replace sewers, we frequently use age as the measure of replacement. So 100-year-old sewers all have to be replaced, 80-year-olds, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. I would say that in the last 20 years, some of those sewers are starting to fall apart. And the way we're putting in those private side laterals, the pipe from your house, mm-hmm. I would say they're built to last 10 or 20 years. So you buy a house with a 75-year life, you've got a sewer lateral that maybe will last 10 or 20 years, and then you're going to have a breakage problem or a flooding problem or whatever. So this is a big, important problem.
I wonder if just the housing industry has been so booming here for the last, 10, 20 years, I guess, in particular, that they just want to get these houses up so quickly
and get out
and, you know, move along because the demand is so... Sure. Ferocious, right?
Sure. So my issue with this is that the developers make a profit from their developments, and they walk away with their profit and you know, do their thing, obviously. But the municipality and actually the taxpayers are left holding the bag for... Because taxpayers pay for that. So we pay rates for our sewer system. I pay $3.05 per meter cube for sewage in Kitchener-Waterloo. All of that extra water just goes on my sewage bill. And no resident would be aware that developers are leaving leaky sewers in the ground, going away, and then the residents are paying for the next 75 years. So
more acute inspection on the front end would help us a lot on the back end.
Yes, absolutely.
Gotcha. Thank you for this.
Thank you, Steve.
That's
appreciated.
Barbara Robinson, the president of Norton Engineering. Appreciate you making the trip in from KW for us.
Thank you so much, Steve.
The Agenda with Steve Paikin is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario, helping businesses stay on the right side of change with strategic thinking, insightful decisions, and business leadership. Are you on the right side of change? Ask an Ontario CPA.